everybody. I hope you are all doing well. I have missed you and our practices together. I am going to be recording a class weekly so that we can all stay cool and calm during the craziness and whatever your life is like, whatever your new normal is over these next weeks and months. I hope that we can all use yoga and the breath to stay present and to be calm and patient and kind with ourselves and with those around us, so that we can make the most of this time and use it for positive change and growth. So we are going to start seated, feeling free to sit on the edge of a blanket or a bolster or a chair, grounding down into your sitting bones, lifting up in the chest, shoulders up, back and down. Crown of the head is lifting up towards the ceiling, shoulders are down away from your ears, sitting up nice and tall, being relaxed about it, inviting you to close your eyes, start to watch the breath. Following an inhale in, watching it turn to an exhale, flow out. Letting go of your day, letting go of whatever was going on before you took time for your practice, letting go anything that's to come in the future, just being present. Scanning your body for any tension, and with each exhale, just feeling it flow out. Relaxing your jaw. We'll be using the breath to stay present during our practice. So whenever your mind wanders and you notice that you're thinking about something or worrying about something or feeling anxious about something, just notice where your mind went and then bring it back to the breath. Puppy on a leash wants to go wherever it wants to go, but you will bring your attention back to your breath. We're going to start to deepen the breath. We'll bring both hands to our belly. And a little breath practice here before we get going. So on the inhale, breathing down into the belly, belly expands. On the exhale, belly floats back towards the spine. Inhale, belly expands. Exhale, belly floats back. So we're going to work on our three-part breath. So we'll keep one hand on the belly and bring one hand to our ribs on the side. On the inhale, breathe first into the belly. Then keep breathing, ribs expand. Then exhale in the opposite direction. Ribs close in, belly squeezes in. Inhale, belly, ribs, exhale, ribs, squeeze, belly squeezes the air out. Now keep one hand on your belly and bring one hand up to your heart on your chest. So this is the last of the three parts of the three-part breath. So inhale, belly, ribs, then keep breathing in so that your chest lifts a little. Then exhale in the opposite order, chest falls, ribs squeeze, belly squeezes. three-part breath. Inhale, belly, ribs, chest. Exhale, chest falls, ribs squeeze, belly squeezes. And bring your hands down, but continue practicing your deep three-part breath. Inhale, belly, ribs, chest, lots of air in. Exhaling, chest, ribs, belly. All the old air out. So all the stale air out so you can get a full deep breath, fresh air. Exercising our lungs, using the breath to energize our body. Deep three-part breaths. We're going to add one more piece to our breathing, the ocean breath. Practice it first with an open mouth. So we're going to inhale and then exhale, saying H-A, like when you're fogging up a mirror. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, ha. Now we're going to inhale, ha, and exhale, ha. Now we're going to close the mouth and keep doing that same thing. And that is what we're looking for, that ocean sound. You can hear it. It's like a whispering hum. So that ocean breath is called Ujjayi breath, Sanskrit. It is constricting the back of your throat so that we can get deeper and more quality breaths in. So that ocean breath combined with the three-part breath is the ideal breath that we will be using during our practice. So inhaling and exhaling, ocean breath, connecting that with your deep three-part breaths. And close your eyes and tune into the sound of your ocean breath. Inhaling, belly, ribs, chest, full oxygen in. Exhaling, chest, ribs, belly. Deep three-part ocean breath. Sometimes tend to think you've been buried. Perhaps you've been planted, grow, bloom. My mom always used to say, bloom where you're planted. So may we use this next time in our lives to bloom, to grow, to bloom and grow with every breath, one breath at a time. Joining your hands at heart center, setting an intention for your practice, thinking of any ways that you want to grow or bloom, planting a seed towards becoming your best self. During the practice, we'll come back to the breath again and again. We'll come back to our intention, and our practice will be dedicated to that. Blinking your eyes open, sitting up nice and tall. We're going to warm up the neck. So we're going to breathe in deep. Exhale, looking over one shoulder. Inhale to the center. Exhale, looking the other way. feel the length in the back of your neck. Inhale, chin towards the ceiling. Shoulders are down, away from your ears. Exhale, chin to chest. Inhale, chin towards the ceiling. Exhale, chin to chest. And then head in the center. Deep breath in. Exhale, ear towards the shoulder. Feeling the length on the side of your neck. Inhale, center. Exhale, other ear to other shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, ear to shoulder, listening to your body always, never moving into pain. Exhale, chin to chest. Now inhale, rolling ear to shoulder. Exhaling, chin to chest. Inhale, other ear to the other side. One more time on each side. Do the shoulders. So we're going to inhale the shoulders up towards our ears. Deep breath in. And then on the exhale, we're going to drop them down and sigh it out through an open mouth. Inhale, shoulders up, up, up. Exhale, drop them. One more time. Finding some shoulder rolls. Cross one arm on top, hug around, you can walk your fingers to find your tightness level that you like, and then drop your shoulders down, find that deep three-part breath, belly, ribs, chest, feeling your shoulder blades stretch behind when you're fully inhaled, and then exhaling chest, ribs, belly. Ocean breath. Finding out what you like and doing more of that. And the next time you're at the front, reverse. Listening to your breath. Spiraling around, feeling all the places where you can feel it. And then sitting up nice and tall. We're going to inhale, the arms up. Watch the palms come together. Exhale down. Grow taller through the crown of your head. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale down. Exhale your left arm down next to you, stretching. Stay on this side. Keep your opposite hip down on the floor, starting to kind of work your chest open, looking up. Deep breaths, stretching through your top fingers. On your next inhale, reaching tall in the center, trying to touch the ceiling, and then exhale to the other side. Deep breaths in, trying to create more space in between your ribs on the inhale, so full breath to the belly. Ribs and chest. On your next inhale, reach tall in the center. Exhale, your right hand comes across to the knee. Your left hand goes behind you, twisting to the left. On the inhales, crown of the head reaching to the ceiling. On the exhales, twisting a little more, bringing the breath out of you. Twisting is good for digestion. Massages your internal organs, releasing toxins. Twisting is healthy. On your next inhale, untwist, reach tall in the center, full breath in, and then exhale, twisting to the other side. Looking towards the back shoulder. On your next inhale, unwind, reach tall in the center. And then exhale, arms down and clasp them behind you, opening up the chest. Want more, you can try to bring your hands away from your back. Pull them out. Deep breaths. Full three-part breath, feeling how it feels when you breathe all the way up to your chest. Feeling your chest stretch. In general, sending the air on the inhale to wherever it's tight. And then on the exhale, feeling that part relax. On your next inhale, unclasp your hands, reach them up tall, and then exhale, folding forward, releasing your head, releasing your jaw, deep breaths. On your next inhale, walking your hands back towards you, sitting up nice and tall one more time, checking in with how you feel. We're going to make our way into table on our hands and knees. So in table, checking in the back that your knees are under your hips, in the front your wrists are under your elbows, under your shoulders. Fingers are spread wide, so we're going to find that cow and cat shaped back again like while we were sitting. On the inhale, spine bends down, tailbone rolls up, head looks up, shoulders but down away from your ears, full three-part breath in. Then on the exhale, belly button goes towards the spine and towards the ceiling, tailbone drops, head drops, complete exhale. Inhale and cow. And then coming to a neutral spine, using your belly muscles to kind of hold your table flat. Now lift the left leg out the back. Point and flex your ankle, roll it around. Finding a spot, so we're going to be balancing here on two parts. So finding a spot directly under your eyesight to stare at, to focus on, so that you can lift your right arm in the front. On the inhale, hand and foot stretch apart. We're going to inhale and stretch. And on the exhale, we're going to bring our knee and our elbow towards each other. Do a little crunch for the exhale. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, crunch. One more time. And crunch. And then back to table. We'll do a cow and a cat to reset the spine. And then neutral spine, back to table. Get that on the other side. So we're gonna send the right leg out the back. Point and flex the foot. Find your spot to stare at, spreading your fingers wide in the front, pushing the right hand, grounding that right hand down because the left hand's gonna be lifting up. Grounding down in your left top of your foot. Extending the left arm out, shaking someone's hand. Inhale, stretch, reach the foot and hand apart. Finding your breath. We're going to inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. One more time. And then back to table, the cow and cat. And then back to table. We're going to walk our hands forward a step. We're just going to shift our hips forward to half plank. Just a few breaths here, feeling our core engaged. Feeling free to go to full plank if you're feeling strong. On your next exhale, we're going to lower down to the floor. We're going to bring our hands forward and our elbows, Sphinx pose. So we're going to flow and then hold. So first of all, make your back leg muscles active. So connect your legs down. Legs are active to anchor you down in the back. And we're just going to inhale with the head up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and hold. Shoulders are shrugged back. Head is looking up as much as feels good. Finding your breath. Sending the air to your belly. Feeling your belly pressing on the floor. One more inhale, go up a little higher. And then exhale the whole body down. Bring your hands under your shoulders and push up and back through table and then back into child's pose. So the knees are open, big toes together. Stretching your arms out, forehead to the floor, or to bring your hands back by your feet over, you could put your hands under your forehead, make a little pillow. Finding your deep breaths. Sending the breath to the belly. Feeling the low back expand also. Connecting with the sound of your ocean breath. Few more breaths here. Mm-hmm. shoulders, hugging your elbows in. We're going to be doing another back bend, so we're going to do cobra. So again, activating your legs in the back, legs are active, muscles are kind of tight to hold you down back there, fingers are spread, shoulders shrugging back, elbows hugging in. We're going to inhale, lifting up, looking up, exhale, down. Inhale it up. Exhale it down. This time we'll lift it up and hold. So again, shrugging your shoulders down, hugging your elbows in, finding where you want to lift. Legs are active in the back. Deep breaths to the belly. Feeling your back bending, working on kind of getting your upper back bending also. One more inhale, go up a little higher. And exhale the whole body down and then push yourself up and back through table. Back to rest in child's pose. Forehead to the floor, forward to your hands. Coming to child's pose in between the back bends. So we're doing these back bends to help undo all the forward hunching we do in the world. And then this forward fold in child's pose in between is just a nice kind of rest going in the opposite direction. So finding your deep breaths, feeling your back expand. On the exhales, sinking down, relaxing, letting go of anywhere there's tension. Inhale, send the breath to where it's tight. Exhales, feeling that part, those parts relax. Connecting with your ocean breath, connecting with your intention. On your next breath, coming forward to table, a cow and a cat. Neutral spine, walk your hands forward, shift your hips forward to half plank, deep breath. On the exhales, really pull your belly in, get all the air out. On your next exhale, lowering down for our last back bend, upward facing dog. So again, kind of anchoring down the back, tightening up your legs. This time we're going to move our hands back by our chest, fingers spread wide. We're going to flow and then hold again. So inhale, pushing up. Exhale, folding down. So upward dog is the deepest of the back bends we're doing. So if it already feels like you, it's too much, you just move your hands forward and do cobra again, or you could do sphinx. So pick the back bend you like. If this one's feeling kind of deep, we're going to inhale it up. Exhale it down. And then inhale it up. So we're going towards straight arms. You always have a bend. Kind of even lifting your top legs off the ground. Legs are active, shoulders shrugged down. You're pushing up, looking up, deep breaths to the belly. One more breath in. Exhale the whole body down. Push up, back into child's pose once more. To rest here, find your deep breath, feel your low back expanding with the full breath in, another breath or so years. On your next inhale, making your way back to the table of cow and a cat. Neutral spine. So we're going to do a few lunges here. So we're going to bring our left foot forward in between our hands. You want to check that your ankle is under your knee. Your knee is going past the foot. Just scooch the foot forward. Make your back leg tight. Tighten up your leg muscles. Tighten up your hip. And then bring your hands up to your hips. Shrug your shoulders up. Back and down. Pushing the floor away in the front, especially with the heel. Crown of the head is lifting to the ceiling. Everything that's on the floor is pushing equally, using the top of the foot in the back. Inhale the arms up. Exhale down to the heart. Two more times. Inhale. We're going to bring the hands to the floor, tuck the back toes under, and push forward with as many steps as you need to come to a forward fold. Release your head. You can have a good side bend in the knees. Say no with your head. Say yes with your head. Just make sure your neck is relaxed. We're going to bring our hands to our shins and come up halfway. So take the bump out of your back. Shrug your shoulders back. Your head and your tailbone are reaching towards opposite sides of the room. Deep breaths. One more deep breath in. On the exhale, fold back down, bring your hands to the floor, step back with your left leg. We're going to create that lunge shape on the other side. So uncurl the toes in the back, your right leg is forward, checking that your ankle is under the knee, and if it's not, scooch it forward. Bringing your hands to your hips, shrug your shoulders up, back, and down. Crown of the head lifting towards the ceiling. Inhale the arms up. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Slowly bringing the hands back to the floor, bring the front leg back to table, a cow and a cat, just to reset the spine, and then neutral spine. We're going to curl the toes under in the back, and like a string was lifting your low back up to the ceiling, we're going to push up, back to downward dog. In the front, your hands are, fingers are spread wide and your hands are pushing the floor away, so your hips go up and back. We'll just take a minute here, bending one knee at a time. You can go up and down on the toes, anything that feels good. Down dog, make sure your neck is relaxed. Release your head, release your jaw. Deep breaths. Looking forward in between your hands, and we're going to walk our feet up to our hands to the forward fold again. And we'll just sway back and forth a few times. Find a little movement here. And then we'll grab opposite elbows. Just hang out for a few breaths. Release your head again. Release your head towards the floor. Say no with your head. Say yes with your head. Make sure your neck is relaxed. And then connect to your deep ocean breaths. So anytime your head is below your heart, you are doing an inversion, which is healthy for you in many ways. Also bringing fresh oxygen to your brain. Release your arms. We're going to bring our hands to our shins again. Come up halfway. Taking the bump out of your back. Look at number 7. Exhale, fold down. Hands on your shins. Inhale up halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms out to the sides. Coming all the way up. Exhale, your hands to your heart, standing tall in mountain pose. Grounding down through all four corners of your feet, spreading your toes out. Feet are parallel, hips width apart. Pulling your front legs in, tucking your tailbone down, bringing your shoulders up, back, and down. Chin level with the floor. Feeling tall and strong like a mountain, finding your deep breath. I'm going to bring the arms down. Inhale them up. Watch the palms come together. Exhale, swan dive, leading with the heart, hinging at the hips, folding all the way down. Hands on your shins, inhaling up halfway. Exhale, folding all the way back down. Arms out to the sides, inhaling all the way up. Exhale, pulling your hands down to your heart. I'm going to do that a few more times. Inhaling the arms up. Exhale, folding forward, leading with the heart, all the way down. Inhaling up halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms up to the sides, coming all the way up. Energy in the fingertips. Exhale, your hands to your heart. One more time. Inhale it up. Exhale, fold. Inhale up halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms out to the side. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to your heart, standing tall. Deep breath in. On the exhale, step back with your right foot and pivot your back foot so that your feet are perpendicular. So you want the heel on the front foot in line with the arch in the back foot. Spread all of your toes out wide in the front. Bend your knee a little bit and send the left arm out front and the right arm out back for warrior two. So gazing out over the front fingers. Fingers are in line with the toes and the knee. So if your knee's kind of folding in, bring it in line. Deep breaths on the inhale. Crown of the head reaching towards the ceiling. On the exhale, sinking in the hips, feeling strong in your warrior, feeling your hands stretching apart from each other. Finding your deep breath. Finding your calm in the pose, using the breath to keep you present. Flipping your front hand over on your next inhale. That hand up towards the ceiling, back hand down by the back leg, reverse warrior. On the inhale, reaching your fingers to the ceiling. On the exhale, sinking in the hips, gazing up towards the top hand. One more inhale, reach. cartwheeling the arms back to warrior two. Shifting out over the front leg, bending the front arm, bringing it down to the leg. Back arm comes up by your ear. Side ankle pose. Feeling the line of energy between your fingertips on top and the back edge of your back foot. Opening up in the chest, looking up towards the ceiling. Deep breaths. On your next inhale, cartwheeling the arms back to warrior two. On your next inhale, pushing up the back foot, coming back to mountain at the top of your mat. Standing tall, breathing deep, and we'll get that on the other side. So here we go, deep breath in. On the exhale, stepping back this time with your left foot, pivot your back foot, set your feet up, set up your foundation, bending in the front knee, checking that the front foot is in line with the arch and the back foot, spreading all your toes out, sending the right arm out in front and the left arm out in back, looking out over your front fingers, checking that your fingers, knee and toes are all in a line. On the inhale, stretching your arms apart. On the exhale, sinking in the hips. Finding your calm by connecting with your breath. Flip the front hand over. Inhale the front arm up to the ceiling. Back arm down in the back. Reverse warrior. On the inhale, breathing deep. Stretching up, trying to create more space in between the ribs. On the exhale, sinking in the hips. Deep breath in. Reach, and then exhale, cartwheel on the arms, back to warrior two. Shifting forward over the front leg, bending the front arm, bringing it down to the knee. Back arm comes up by the ear, feeling the long diagonal from your fingertips on top down to the back edge of your back foot. Working the chest open to the ceiling, looking up, deep breaths. On your next inhale, cartwheeling the arms back to warrior two, feeling strong. Like a warrior, not a worrier. On your next inhale, pushing off your back foot, coming back to mountain, standing tall, top of your mat. Dropping the arms down, inhaling them up. Exhale, folding forward, bringing your hands down, stepping back. Downward dog for the last time. So any last little movements here before we make our way towards the floor, feel free. And then coming back to table, a cow and cat for old time's sake. Exhale. And then coming back to sitting, extending your legs out, making your way down onto your back. And when you get there, hugging your knees in, rocking them around, massaging your low back out on the floor. You can circle your knees. Going to bring both feet to the floor with your knees facing towards the ceiling. You're going to bring your left ankle to your knee. Pushing the left knee away, feeling the stretch in your hip. Then we're going to lift both legs off, lift your right leg off the floor and grab around behind the back of your right leg to find a hip stretch here. want more of a stretch, letting it out if it's feeling like too much. Maybe you want to try straightening the bottom leg and see if you like that. Maybe you want to bend the bottom leg and grab around in the front of the shin. So finding a good stretch for your hip. And then finding your breath. On the inhale, send the air to wherever it's tight. On the exhale, feel that part relax. On your next exhale, release to the floor, but keep your left foot up. We're going to bring our arms to the floor in cactus. So kind of bend at 90 degrees, take a deep breath in. Then on the exhale, drop both legs to the right. And then your head looks to the left. So we've done some different twisting today. This is an easy twist, so scooch it around in any way so it feels good. Then find your deep breaths. Sending the air to your twisting belly, bend your ribs, bend your chest, exhaling in the opposite order, three-part breath. Connecting with the sound of your ocean breath, and on the exhale, letting go everywhere, relaxing down, melting down into the floor. Twist around in any way that feels good to your spine, then settling in, connecting with your breath. Thank you. come to our final relaxation pose, Shavasana. So extending the legs out. Arms are going to be down at your sides. Shrug your shoulders down away from your ears. Palms facing up. Separating your feet 10 inches or more and just letting your feet kind of flap open, nice and relaxed. Rocking your head back and forth a couple times and then letting your head settle in the middle with your nose in line with your belly button. Closing your eyes. Scanning your body for any remaining tension. With each exhale, letting any tension, any worries, any stresses flow out of you, down and out of your fingertips, down and out of your feet and your toes. We'll be using this time in Shavasana to take all of the good work we've done during our practice, all of the moving and bending and twisting and breathing, letting all of that good stuff sink down into our soul. Bringing your attention to the crown of your head, relaxing there, relaxing your forehead, relaxing your eyes, your eyelids, your cheeks, relaxing your jaw, relaxing your throat, the shoulders, relaxing your arms, your fingers, relaxed and curled up, relaxing your chest, your belly, your hips, your thighs, your knees, relaxing your calves, your ankles, your feet, and your toes. Feeling all the places where the floor is touching your back and your body, rocking your head back and forth from side to side, starting to deepen your breath, stretching your arms overhead and your feet in the opposite direction, and slowly making your way onto your side, curled up. Taking a few breaths here in transition. Feeling grateful for your practice. Feeling grateful for all of your blessings. Pushing down with your top hand and helping yourself up to a comfortable tall seat. Sitting up nice and tall, being relaxed about it, keeping your eyes closed and your focus inward. Feeling how relaxed you feel, promising yourself you're going to keep some of this relaxation with you. Knowing that anytime with a few deep ocean breaths, you can feel it whenever you want. Joining your hands at heart center, releasing your intention, knowing the seed has been planted towards becoming your best self. Also remembering always to bloom where you are planted. Thank you guys for practicing with me. Namaste.